Welcome to Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning. I'm the master taster of Whisky.com, and today we have quite a rare bottle here in my cask. It's an independently bottled Glen Elgin. It's 24 years old, quite old, vintage 1991, from the independent bottler Ian McLeod in its Dunvegan series. And Dunvegan is a small village on the Isle of Skye. And atop of this village, the castle of the McLeods is situated. It's from the 13th century, if I'm right. And it's worth a visit. I don't know if it's still visitable by the public, but typically those old castles have to earn money for the renovation works always going on. So this is a Glen Elgin from the Speyside. It's in the southeast of Elgin, the capital of the Speyside. The wood type is a sherry butt. It's 24 years old. The cask number is 8,291, and there had been an outcome of 488 bottles. The ABV is 52.7, which is cask strength. It's uncolored, unchill filtered, just neat as it should be. And it's rare, and the price is around 170 euros, dollars, pounds, wherever you live. The variances in prices is very, very high. So here we go. Glen Elgin is not famous. It's famous for being into several blends, a lot of sherry, in the whiskey industry. So it works as a, say, tier two or tier three distillery in the in the background of the whiskey industry. And lately there had been an original bottling with 18 years of age, which is much more expensive than this one. And it's not completely from sherry casks, I think. So this one is the real stuff. Yeah. So there is an alcoholic note in it, definitely 52.7. Yeah, 52.7. A lot of sherry on top of that. And then oakiness shines through. And then the typical vanilla caramel. And it's really heavy, it's strong, it's full. It's already a little bit spice in it, a little bit spicy. So this is a full, mature, 24 years of age in oak cask in a sherry butt. This leaves marks on the whiskey. So, and I think I will dilute it a little bit because it's so intense in aroma. Not too much, just to come down below 50. Yeah, and it opens up. Yeah. A little fresher. There's some orange aroma in it. Juice oranges, sweet juice oranges. Yeah, the vanilla shines through more than before. So opening up delivers lighter, more juicy, fruity aromas. In the beginning, it's a dark, old, full, mature, oaky whiskey. And now with a little bit of water, it's fruity, juicy oranges. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Still strong. Yeah. And the bitterness comes through. Dark chocolate. Oakiness. Spicy, a little bit of sweetness still there, and the juicy oranges move over to marmalade, so the bitter peel of the orange. In the aftertaste, some coffee, bitter coffee, espresso. Yeah. full, intense, mature whiskey, yeah. Mm-hmm. Juicy oranges, and then moving over to chocolate. Really a good one. Yeah, thank you for watching. Stay tuned, there's always more to come.